Welcome to Los Scandalous Shake and Bake Arena, home of the Los Scandalous Vault and Damned.
Wait, what? Both teams share the same arena?
Yeah, except when they're playing each other, and then I don't know who the home team is, really.
Now I'm confused, Grim.
Remember, in the NFL, we encourage you to play with your food. He's probably lining up against you. The Malice Hellboys take on the Los Scandalous Vaults. Welcome to NFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Yo, man, nobody can touch me with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
It's time to tune in, turn on, and drop what you're doing, because NFL Game Day is on the air. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. So what's the game plan for the home team today, Bricks?
I think they gotta keep it simple. A little cough syrup, maybe smoke a little Untidy Pod pregame so they can keep their heads in the game. I mean, literally, you don't want to get decapitated on the opening kickoff.
I say go after the refs early and often. No mercy.
Call that about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
And that'll be 2nd down and 4. He is running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. 1st down. And it's 1st and 10. It's a punishing hit. And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. And he fumbles it, Bricks. That was a screwed up play if I ever saw one. He broke free and has open field in front of him.
Somebody get that guy a beer, because he just saved me $1,000.
It's 1st and 10. A pickup of about 3 on that play. Second down and 7. And the defense just knocked the wind out of that quarterback. Third down and long. And there's a huge gain, and this offense is rolling.
Marvin, that was a pass play. Rolling plays are in bowling.
Well, they couldn't pick up a 1st down, so now they have to punt. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. Nice catch, and he turns on the... Oh, with the brutal hit! And it's 1st and 10. Get the 1st down and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's 1st and 10. broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig about to blow? Hey, smells like an oven-baked port-a-john in here. We're a freaking fracking accident waiting to happen. Don't nobody light a match.
And he just slipped away like a... And that'll give him four more downs to punish the defense. And you better believe they will. And it's first and ten. And he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's no way to stop him. Unless, of course, you kill him.
Oh, look at that freak go! He's unstoppable!
And he rumbles into the end zone for the score.
I hope he's not gonna dance now.
Should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Oh, nice hit. First and ten. I'm gonna say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. Second down and seven. When it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grin. It'd have been fun to gamble with my own teeth.
And it's first and ten. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. Second and eight to go. And that is caught for a first down. And it's first and ten. Sandwich. First down and seven. And he breaks through for a touchdown. Listen to this crowd. And if you don't understand why refs are hated even more than kickers, well, there's your answer, Bricks. Jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not gonna take it anymore. First down and forever. He might have managed to dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in, you know, the usual money, bodies, coffee cans filled with, well, you know, mostly coffee. Tastes better, I guess.
That's the end of the first quarter, and it's still anyone's game.
Oh, could it be mine?
Second down, and ain't gonna happen, partner. And that's a pick. And now the quarterback second and eight to go. Just some good old downhill running there as he picks up the first down. And it's first and ten. If you don't think you can make the interception, batting it down is the next best thing.
Great advice, Grim. That receiver's gonna go far in this league if he listens to you.
I wasn't talking to... never mind. Yes, Brick, he will. And picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I gotta, hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time. First and ten. Boom! Second down and six. QB passes it for maybe a yard. They've got to open up the offense here, Bricks. Third down and five. And it bombs away. The defense has to do a better job of watching out for that dirty trick.
I don't know.
Punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross.
And the runner is moving crazy fast. Look at the pass he's taking upfield. No return on this punt. The defense will just down it.
I can't tell if he's smart or scared. Either way, the ball's down.
And it's first and ten. And that's how you run the football. A pickup of seven on the play.
Why is it that more mentally disturbed clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
Yeah, they're all in politics, apparently. Second and three. The quarterback has had enough and calls a murder ball dirty trick to lay waste to the defense.
And the defender just got caught.
Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. Quarterback finds his man for the first down.
Hey, you kill a ref. It's not murder if they have it coming, right? Take the hit. Do something about that ref, you pussies.
I only mean you have it.
Second down and a lot. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. And the ref somehow escapes the onslaught. Here comes the penalty. Second down and a... And they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And this guy looks like Thor on a revenge. Oh, he took a leap and hit the ball, knocked out. Fumble!
He's got a case of fumbleitis.
This Thor can really dance, huh?
He was a ballet minor in college. Then it wasn't
shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
For a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's first and ten. I think the defenders are scared of this guy, Bricks, and they have every right to be.
Yeah, he's a murderer!
And it's first and ten. Oh no, it's a sticky ball and dirty trick. The defense pretty much turned the ball into a yo-yo of doom.
Did you ever think you'd say that, Grim? A yo-yo of doom?
No, my friend, I didn't. I love this job. And we're at the 2-minute warning. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. They pick up a nice chunk of yards on that pass play. They stump the clock with their first timeout, leaving them with two in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
One in for the first down. The quarterback is controlling the clock like the clock is into it. I know I am. And it's first and ten.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
And they are out of timeout. The clock just became their greatest enemy.
Really? The clock? The clock, Grim? I can smash a clock. That's not a great enemy.
We're not talking about waking up at the crack of noon. We're talking about the NFL.
And the crowd goes wild. Touchdown! Touchdown! And they line up for the extra point. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
First and ten. When the defense calls thunderclap, the offense is toast.
Oh, did he ever get zapped? Reminds me, did we hear that Zappa song, Watch Out Where the Huskies Go? Don't you eat that yellow snow? When I was a kid, I always ate the yellow snow. They were like lemon snow cones. But them fudge ice cream sandwiches, they didn't taste so good.
Changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up, too?
That's a gain of 7 yards on the catch. Nicely done. Second and three. third and two. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage. Thank God he's still got his leg. He's going to need all of it for this kick. He is automatic. Nice kick.
Boring. Just give him the points and let's move on.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. The teams line up for the kickoff to start the second half. These guys will have to play a lot harder to make it a game. Well, either that or kill and cheat more.
I'm the greatest, I tell you.
Just one, just in some butter time.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Second down and 10. That's a 6-yard gain. Third and 4. Talk about Butterfingers. He should have had that one. Kick is no guarantee.
Sure it is. If he misses, he's fired. Guaranteed.
He's got the distance, and the kick is good. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and 10. Game and pick up the first. Nicely done. And it's first and 10.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
Second down and 6. For every yard, and then catch will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And it's first and 10. And he runs it for 4 yards. Second down and 6. Beast boost. why go for one when you can go for two?
It's always been my philosophy, but Fritz can't even get one. Oh, you're talking about points.
And he gets into the end zone for the conversion.
Why didn't the skeleton dance at the rock club, Grim?
I don't know.
He had no body to dance with. That's a pretty good one.
Looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck off. That was just a one-time thing.
And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's first and ten. Defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick. Second down and 10. That run is good for 9 yards. And that'll bring up third and one. First and 10. And it picks up 4 on that pass and catch. Second down and 6. Just a great run for a touchdown.
Hey, man, you see that? That's right, you can't handle this. You can't handle what I got. Yeah, get the hell out of here, man.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Straight through the uprights. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's first and 10. Comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. Second down and 7. First and 10. Nice pickup for 6 yards. And that'll be second down and 4.
Not one, not two.
Oh, man, the offense called a murder ball.
That's a little on the nose, don't you think?
When I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a...
Another bullshit penalty. How long are these guys going to take this? Second down and long. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Second down and ain't going to happen, partner. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. Third down, and the QB is saying his prayers. Oh, nice hit! Comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. That's the end of three, and it's anyone's game. Hang on tight, the fourth quarter is about to begin. Now here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. The return man catches the ball and heads upfield. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. Second down and six. Warp speed, engage! And he picks up maybe four on that play. Third down and three. And that'll be a first down. You know, Bricks, a lot of people have gotten pass happy in this league. Nice to see some old school mano a mano on the turf, huh? And it's first and 10. The ground game should be their bread and butter. A gain of 8 right there.
Hey, anyone seen that Korean kid yet with my barbecue?
Last time I ordered Korean, I got Kim Jong-il.
Second down and 2. Third down, and the punter is warming up. And they'll line up for the punt here. Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. Oh, with the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. Looks like a pass, and it's bouncing right back to the QB. Oh, it's the sticky ball dirty trick.
Zoom in on his face, then his crotch. I want to see if he cries or pisses himself first.
Oh, Second down and more than the QB would like.
Don't worry, if he shot.
Oh, welcome to Fumbletown, USA. Population, this guy. Well, he should be more careful when he hurdles. He's at the 10. Touchdown! And he rips off a game-breaking run for the score. At some point, they're going to need to put this ref out of his misery.
How about now, for instance? Here's a hit. Dirty tricks. Attack the ref.
And that'll be second and eight. Defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. And it's first and 10. Man, what a hit that was. And it's first and 10. When it feels like they had their teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grin. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
And it's first and 10. Quarterback passes for a touchdown. Well, some would argue that demons don't have a place in this league, but with moves like that, I have to disagree.
You're just saying that because he'd rip your face off and use it for bookbinding.
I don't see how that's not a valid reason. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Oh, man, he really wants it.
And it's first and 10.
Sebo runs away from the pass marker? That's a good clue that something's not right.
I don't know.
Second down and 10. That's a catch for a 4-yard gain. Third down and 6. Pow! With the brain scrambler! Quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and plays really fast.
Why would they do that?
He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. And it's first time out under 2 minutes. The chess game has begun.
It's like chess, only you can kill people.
The offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you mo-
And another interception. That, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit.
Can you fake it to me?
first and 10. And he picks up about 6 on the play. And the D takes their second time out, hoping for a miracle.
I witnessed a miracle once. A player was brought back from the dead.
That's not a miracle, partner. That's just how the NFL works. This guy's a brick shithouse. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy. Their last timeout. The defense can't bend or break. They've got to get a stop here. And it's first and 10. And he laterals the ball. Man, these guys like playing hybrid. That run is good for 10 yards. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener. Sorry, partner. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. Sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that play. The Bolts get their butts handed to them today and lose the game in front of their home team fans. And let's go down to the field and hear the MVP. He's a real role model for the kids, Bricks. That is, if you want your kids to be a roid-raging narcissist with uncontrollable verbal diarrhea.
Oh, that personality disorder has a name. It's called autotropism.
With Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation.